Previously on Drag Showdown.
I'm still here. Here. Here.
Crystal did some clowning, if you ask me.
She lit herself on fire.
I am just filler at this point.
That is so fierce. I don't know. I am so happy. I am so proud of what I delivered this week. Take them to the parents that I'm on. I got forget to bring and check
if I'm planning because you want to tell. I'm just curious. Narcotica, you have won the lip sync and you will be continuing on into the next episode.
Thank you.
Welcome to the most avant-garde competition on YouTube. The winner of the competition will receive a prize package consisting of contacts courtesy of contactlenshub.com, 3 mixes provided by Robin from Human Resources, makeup courtesy of Pretties for Your Face, a wig styling courtesy of Essence Wigs, a wig styling courtesy of Pretty Good Wigs, and a fan art drawing of their drag character courtesy of Luke Murray Art.
Alright, we're doing this in one take.
Skip the shit. I got a lot to say.
Good evening, DS Divas. Welcome back to Drag Showdown, Season 4, Episode 9. So it is currently bedtime here in the Roland household, so I just took my nightly shower and I'm preparing for bed, and I just decided to throw something on to Phone Confessionals.
Welcome to episode 9 of Drag Showdown. It's the chemo queen, and guess who isn't in the hospital? Whoop, 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 whoop.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to Drag Showdown episode 9. 9 episodes is a long time. I thought about that too when I just said that. We're still here. I mean, this is how I feel for the world. Like a fucking clown. Yeah, that.
Let's start with week 8. I am very upset that Miss Martha is gone again.
Well, I am sad I had to send one of my closest friends in the competition home. I am so grateful to still be in this competition. You won't find me slipping up like that again, I promise you.
When Martha came back, I was like really, really excited. Obviously, was hoping that she would make it to the top 4, but when you come back in a competition, it's kind of an uphill battle. And I think Trixie said this once, you like have to win like every challenge to like make it to the top, because there's already like one eye on you, or 4. Crystal wears glasses.
That's because the first time I've actually done really badly, and it sucks. I feel like I hyped up a bad performance, and after putting so much time and effort into both my runway and my challenge, to hear that I didn't do so well really made me feel insecure. But I get it, I'm not gonna dwell over the negative. I understand that because I've set the bar really high for myself, that when I don't deliver, it hits a lot harder. I just felt really shitty afterwards, but it was kind of the kick in the ass I needed to get me back on track.
Despite what everyone thinks, I knew every word to Rubber Doll. There was a communication error with Crystal and I, but that was a fierce dance challenge. Everyone turned it, I feel like.
Narcotica did really well in her lip sync. One thing she's said that she's very worried about with her drag is performing and lip syncing. She thinks that she's at a detriment because of her leg. And so I think this like proved that like she's a good performer, and like I'm happy she got a good lip sync, and but that was shown to the world that she is a good performer.
So Tara Bell won last week. Ooh! I'm very proud of her.
So I won last week. I finally got my second win. And I couldn't be more happy and joyful and elated and joyful and happy, and I'm really glad I won.
She was looking forward to last week, especially because of her runway, and mama, it was the best. She made that corset, and I remember the process of her making it. Just pure excellence. That being her second win is kind of crazy to me. Just when I think of Tara, I think winner, so.
I believe I was robbed Now let's get into it, because I can't just say I was robbed without saying why. Tara, I think your look was stunning. Let me get that out of the way. Yada, yada, yada. That look was great. Here's my issues. One, this was a choreography challenge. If this was a lip sync challenge, yes, you could have won, but this was choreography and you were from the waist up. Like, the projector was cool, yada, 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 but it was a choreography challenge. But I believe that I was the best dancer of the week, no offense. Martha did turn it, but I do think I was still the best. Also, I feel like my runway was just as good as Tara Belle's. And I might be crazy, I might be sound like an asshole for that, but I think mine was equal. So, I'm like, where was my win?
I will say, I was kind of expecting Trisha to win the dance challenge because she is our dancing diva, so that was a little surprising for sure.
I think it's that part of the episode that we address the elephant in the room. There was a bit of a situation that happened, and I may or may not have been involved.
Trisha Can versus the cast of Drag Showdown Season 4.
The other day in the group chat, the topic of submitting confessionals was brought up because it was like a day before the episode aired and a few queens still didn't have theirs in, me included. And Daisy explained why she hadn't yet. She talked about how she's going through a lot right now. She recently found out she has clinical depression and she's going to begin getting medicated for it.
I waited until the last possible day. Fucked up, yes. Annoying, yes. I recently have been really struggling with depression.
Trisha decided to... I'll say it. She decided to take out her frustrations on Daisy, proceeding to disregard the mental health struggles that she was just explaining.
Basically, Trisha really hurt me in the moment, especially.
I said some really insensitive things, and since then I have apologized and contacted Daisy, but I have also still stayed away from the group chat because, Miss Acadia, we have a rocky path. And the fact that she chose this to be the time that she could be Joan of Arc, I could not believe.
Miss Girl, I'm talking straight to you now. The way you talked to a fellow castmate was completely out of line. I said it in that DM to you and I'll repeat it here. If you want me to be civil, learn how to be civil first.
Girl, I'm done with you. Literally, she was just waiting to cancel me, so she's gone to me.
Trisha was somebody that I definitely did have respect for. We've talked about this since. It wasn't much of a conversation, but I didn't want it to be because I have lost a lot of respect for her.
Trisha and I are good friends. We've been good friends for a while now. So, like, obviously, I don't want to lose a friend over an online competition thing. I didn't lose all respect for her. I don't think that she's, like, a bad person, you know? It was just... I feel like she was frustrated just with the fact that confessionals weren't submitted. And then so rather on taking it out on the two people who didn't just explain the mental health struggles that they were going through as to why they couldn't film.
So right now in my life, I have really been going through it, and I'm not going to lie, Showdown is pretty much like one of the few joyful things I have left right now. I just want this to be a positive thing I can look back at instead of talking about all the negatives.
So obviously, this isn't my normal like at home confessional setup. Louis's not here. My boyfriend is taking care of him for me. I got discharged from the hospital about a week and a half ago. And so I'm just kind of starting my at home recovery process. Things have been pretty good for me. My pain is manageable. I'm still on bed rest for another 4 weeks, and then I can't put any weight on my bad leg for another 6 weeks. It's gonna be a long recovery process, but I'm strong.
I just think that it's so beautiful of you all to be sending her these messages and these kind words and stuff like that. Like, literally, like, if I'm allowed to say this, like, thank you guys. Cause just the way that lightens her spirit is keep doing what you're doing, y'all.
Hi, it's me again. I forgot to say thank you to literally everyone else in the cast. They made me feel valid in sticking up for me, and that's really what I needed. I want to especially thank the Cicadia for really helping and showing the kind of person that she is and the growth that she's gone through. And I obviously want to thank Tara. I couldn't do any of this without her.
I couldn't handle this all without her. I love you so much. Okay, before I actually cry, thank you. Thank you.
For this episode's mini challenge, we challenged our queens to do their best beauty guru apology videos. Let's see how they did.
Hi, I'm Diane, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Baking While Baking. Now, today's video isn't like any of our other ones. We're not going to be making any yummy, nummy treats. Today, we'll be getting to know Diane better. You and I are in this together. Since my husband is very wealthy, he took me to the best therapist in Calabasas. I had no reason for going, other than my 40th birthday was last week. Now, most of you did comment on my video and wish me a happy birthday, and I thank you so much. But you know it's the
big bad 40.
4-0. That wretched 4-0. So since I'm going through my midlife crisis, I decided to go to the therapist. Now, I didn't have anything that I wanted to talk about in particular, but I just knew that something was fucked up. I wanted the therapist to lead the conversation. By the end of the session, I learned that I hate myself, and the only thing that I cherish is marijuana and baked goods. So for my first step to healing, my therapist, Dr. RuPaul, recommended that I write down all of the bad things that I've done throughout my life and burn it. Set it aflame, light it ablaze. So to kill two birds with one stone, I'm gonna use the paper to roll a blunt later. So as always, I came prepared to filming and I had already written the fucked up shit that I've done. Let me go retrieve. So we have our notepad with all of the reasons. Let's proceed. To my mother, I'm dearly sorry that I stretched out your cucina on my way out because of this fat ass. To my dentist, Dr. Crystal Ball Diva, I deeply apologize for biting off three of your fingers that one time. They did taste marvelous. To Kathleen, back in kindergarten, I stole your nose, and I still have it, and I'm so sorry. I'll mail it back, please send me your address. To my cousin Gertrude, I'm sorry that I stole your underwear and soiled in them, then gave them back. But you know what they say about a girl that can make gold out of white panties. To Officer Mama, Joe Mama, I'm sorry I ran those three red lights. But I'm not sorry I called you a pig. To Mary Berry, I'm sorry that I curb stomped you in middle school. At least you know now not to talk shit. To my sixth grade music teacher, Mrs. Lumpkin, I'm sorry that I deep throated the recorder. It's not my fault it's so phallic. To Pastor Jesus, I'm sorry for dookieing in the confessional. I was just trying to make your Good Friday better. And most of all, to my husband, I'm so sorry for looking so gorgeous all the time. So now that I have all of this written down, I'm gonna go roll a blunt with it. I can't do this shit with nails. And with the power of editing, we have a blunt! Now, I don't know about you, but I'm gonna go enjoy myself. Have a great night.
I, Kellyanne Conway, would like to publicly apologize on behalf of Donald J. Trump for the vile, horrible, degenerate, ableist, homophobic, xenophobic, Islamophobic, ableist, homophobic, racist comments being made about him. Leave Donald alone. Leave him alone. Leave him alone. No president ever has you to deal with more harassment or anything more than Donald. More than Abraham Lincoln at the Ford Theater. He's had to do with more than John F. Kennedy at that parade thing or something. And now Donald has to work almost every day. Knowing that most Americans don't worship the ground he walks on. He built himself from nothing. Just a small loan of $1 million. And two divorces. Three stupid sons. And two daughters he can't even fuck. Yet, even through all of that, he managed to lose $1 billion in the 80s. You guys can't even imagine the storm E. Daniels he's been inside. So just leave him alone. Just leave him alone! Be sure to like, comment, and vote in the 2020 election. You can click the bell to follow Donald on Twitter and keep up with constant controversies. I love you, whites. 4 more years of jail. 4 more years of jail. 4 more years of jail. All right, thank you, guys.
Tara, darling, how do I look? Am I looking good? Am I looking sexy? Am I looking young? Hi guys, Kitty Crackhead here. My name's Kitty Crackhead and I have something special to say today. I would like to apologize for my recent actions regarding my outbursts outside of places like Charlie Sheen's house. After being denied entry to his divorce party, outside the police station the next morning after they released me, and the grocery store, and the horse farm, and the school for the blind and deaf, and Twitter. I'm sorry. And I know my actions can never be undone, but wait. Why am I apologizing again?
Kitty, you have to apologize to the gay people. You're losing followers on Twitter as we speak.
I don't care about the gays. They're a bunch of dumb goodies, fudge factors, taking up the ass and the Lady Gaga all day. And I, personally, hate them. Ugh. Dumb. I'm not apologizing. I am not sorry. I do not care. Kitty, not again. No! Oh, you didn't see me there. I'm the challenge-winning, fashion-forward icon of Drag Showdown Season 4, Tara Bell. And on the behalf of Kitty Crackhead and Kitty Crackhead's management team, I would like to apologize for Kitty's recent outbursts, both in public and on social media. Both Kitty and her management team understand that her words have caused a great amount of hurt and pain to so many of her different fans belonging to so many different minority groups. It's hard to say who Kitty's hurt at this point. So we won't. So from the bottom of our hearts, we're sorry. We hope you can forgive Kitty Crackhead. And remember, don't stop being a kitty cutie. Do you think the kids are gonna like me again after I post my video? Do you think I'll get uncancelled after I post my video? I'm glad the camera's not rolling right now. We aren't filming, right?
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's the Cicada 101, and before this video starts, I just want to say I'm sorry for my appearance. You know, I know it's a little jarring. You know, today I wasn't really putting all my effort into that because I was supposed to be recording a Vivian Westwood haul, but I got a few comments on Twitter, and I think I need to go over them. Also, totally forgot to mention, this video is sponsored by SodaStream. So don't forget to check out the link in my bio and buy one, like, obviously. So I was on Twitter, I was doing my daily scrolling, and all of a sudden I got tagged in a post, and basically it said, "What's your deal?" So basically my deal is you can get 25% off your order when you use code Cicadia at checkout on wordpedia.com. But anyway, I looked at the image and it was this tweet I had written like back in 2011. Like, I totally forgot about that. Like, I totally didn't even know I had Twitter back then. I was like 12. But like, I looked at the image and it said, quote, "Fuck them faggots," end quote. Basically, like, I was like 10. So like, first off, you can't blame me. But I feel like I should warrant a public apology because I get how that's offensive in today's day and age, and that's totally understandable. But like, you guys need to recognize that it's not my fault, because I was a different person back then. I'm like totally different now. I totally respect the gays, and it's like they're 2% of my fan base, so obviously I'm gonna respect them. That tweet was super insensitive, and I totally should have deleted it. So here it is. I'm saying sorry. And like, I don't want to get emotional, but like guys, it wasn't my fault. Like, you need to give me some slack, because like, that was a different person back then, and like, it wasn't me. And you really need to give me just like some time to like grow and breathe. And like, it wasn't okay for everyone to come out and attack me like that. Like, I totally wasn't expecting it, and it was just like, like, I totally wasn't ready. It's just like, oh my god, like, I totally didn't expect that. And I was like, oh my god, how dare you guys. Like, I just like, I wasn't ready. And like, you really need to warn me when you do that, because it's just like, it's so unfair. Like how, like, oh my god, guys, like, I can't. I can't do that. Like I can't do that.
Last up is get it all out.
So recently this video surfaced of me, and it was a video of me educating the masses. Y'all should be grateful. And recently it was just uploaded to Twitter to try to cancel me, when I'm just trying to teach kids how to douche. Sorry that a lot of minors saw it, but I was a minor too. So it's just really not that deep. And just, girl, child, I'm just pissed. The things that, like, the nasty hate comments have been getting, and the disgusting memes about me saying I shit on children. Who says that? Why would I shit on a children? I shat in a toilet. What the fuck? Is this so you guys are getting fucked up for that? It's just really hard. I just recently had a brand deal. It just, I recently just had a brand deal cut out, and it just really made it. If you guys were wondering how I got this makeup look, I'm gonna post a tutorial next week. I'm just really sad, so I don't know if I'm gonna get it edited, but it's just next week. I just want to say I'm sorry that I gave you guys something to watch, and education and entertainment, and you guys can appreciate it. Sorry, you guys. I got a little emotional and I had to quit filming, but I'm back to finish this video off. I just want to say that thank you guys for watching. You guys who stayed subscribed. And I want to say that if you see this and you don't approve and you're going to leave a hate comment, fuck you. Have a nice day.
Huh?
How about crazy do I look?
You look so crazy. You gotta do more. Your makeup's not running. It's not your
The winner of the mini challenge is Tara Bell.
So I finally won a mini challenge. It only took 9 episodes, but I'm glad I finally get to give someone immunity. This week I've chosen to give Daisy immunity, obviously. Tee-hee-hee-hee.
And for this episode's runway challenge, we challenged our queens to do their best Elf Guts inspired look. Let's see how they did. Hello and welcome to Drag Showdown Season 4, Episode 9. I'm your host, Crystal Ball. Joining me as your guest judge for this episode is Brent Blaze.
Hi, I'm Brent Blaze, and I'm super excited to be here.
First up on the runway is Daisy Mae Rowland.
For this runway, I'm serving Neon and Pastel Dolly. Isn't she such a star? Ah.
Coming up next is Narcotica.
I hand-dyed this wig with Sharpies and dismembered over 50 dolls to create this look. I gauged my elf ears and I'm spilling my elf guts all over this runway.
Go! Coming up next is Tara Bell.
I wanted to turn myself into a doll. I was very inspired by Japanese street fashion and Fairy Kay and wanted to really embrace the color palettes of pastel and neon.
Next up is the Cicadia.
Elf Guts figures don't really have a very feminine shape. They don't wear heels. They're very androgynous.
And last but not least is Trisha Can.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. We all saw the elf part of it, and I wanted to get a little more towards Santa Claus. I don't look quite right, but you know, we're kind of looking good. We're looking fierce, and our makeup is on point. Enjoy. Get into it, sis.
All right. Daisy Mae Rowland. I liked this look. I thought it was fitting of the challenge. I like the colored bang. I like the ears. It wasn't the best out of the week, but it wasn't the worst.
I would have to agree. I really like the whole idea of this look. I like the whole like outer space vibe that she's giving.
Next up is Narcotica. I love this one, I really did. I thought Narcotica knew exactly what she was doing, knew exactly what we were looking for, even had like an ear prosthetic, that was really cool. Mm-hmm.
When Crystal had asked me to be here guest judging this challenge, this is exactly what I was hoping to see. It's everything, like, it brings me back to my Candy Kid years, like this look is everything to me.
Next up is Tara Bell. It was cute, she had a little prosthetic where she had a fucking planet in her eyeball. Super cute outfit, super cute everything. I thought it was really neat.
Very well put together. I like how the planet in her eye actually matched the dress itself.
Right, it was like
it was very, it like cohesive. Pulled. Yeah, very cohesive. And if you like, that is very, you can tell she did her research because this is very like Elf Guts pretty much to the T. It's very good.
The Cicadia, I didn't hate this look, but I didn't really love it. I mean, it just...
I love the idea of this
look. I love the idea, but she didn't go as far as everybody else did. I think everyone else kind of pushed the envelope a little bit, and she came out on a hoverboard.
That's my favorite. Honestly, like, as soon as that happened, I was like, cute, that's adorable, but
But I think she was using it as a crutch. She knew, like, her look didn't stack up against everybody else.
She almost depended on that thing coming out,
And last but not least is Trisha Can. I think Trisha went for the wrong elf. She went for Christmas elf and not elf guts. I like that she did like elf guts-ish makeup, but the outfit was too Christmas. Like, I didn't really...
It's cute. It's really cute. I'm not saying it's not, but it's totally not fitting the challenge at all.
Daisy Mae Rowland, you're safe. Trisha Can, I'm sorry, but you are in the bottom two and you will be lip syncing. Narcotica. Congratulations, you're the winner of this week's challenge. Congratulations.
Oh my word.
I put so much hard work into this look and I just thank you so, so much for seeing that.
Tara Bell, you're safe, which means that the Cicadia, I'm sorry, but you are in the bottom two and you will be lip syncing.
I'm on that late night coming, yeah. I'm on that ripped jean cigarette. And the whole world stops just turning as the love fills up our lungs. I'm on that club brown battle scars. I'm on that 3 a.m. bazaar. And the whole world stops just turning as the love fills up our lungs.
Trisha Can, I'm sorry, but unfortunately your road ends here. You have been eliminated. Trisha, I've really come to love your drag and your style, and I'm so proud of what you put out here week after week. I think you've really pushed boundaries. You've really shown people that you are a competitor, and I'm so happy that you're a part of this, and I can't wait to see what you do beyond this competition. Thank you.
This isn't right. This isn't right with my fantasy. This isn't right. I think I had so much more in me for this finale, and I think I've done so well, and I think that I deserve to be in that top four so much. I deserve that spot. And some of these girls do not. And that's what we'll leave that at.